Alright, I'm gonna start a new campaign as the German Empire just to make up for the last one that didn't finish. But it's really not my fault because, like... Oh wait, battle time limit. 20 minutes, that will show CPU moves. Back then when I started that campaign, it was 5.0. But then after, and that's my dogs in the background shaking. Then 5.1 was released, and 5.0, my 5.0 save wasn't compatible with 5.1, so it corrupted it when I downloaded the 5.1 update, and it corrupted it, and I couldn't play it, and I would have to start all over. Would you like to enforce loyal factions? Enforcing loyal factions will try to keep the major alliances of World War I together. Disabling the script will mean a much more random campaign where anything can happen. I really like the randomness, so I'm going to keep that. Alright, so here's the German Empire. At the very start, we're going to take all of our troops. The last campaign, France out-zerged us. And I don't know how that was possible. I was attacking them and I saw like 5 to 6 armies waiting for me. While I had only like 2 armies of peasants. And I was like, how the hell does that happen? It shouldn't. So... that's my dog screaming for attention. He hears me talking, and he's like, hey you, how about talk to me? Alright, so we're going to be working on our economy for a bit. Going to be taking all of our troops. Usually in some campaigns, you got to disable or disband most of your troops because you want to get your economy going. But since this is a World War I kind of game, where and the AI is pretty aggressive, I got to admit. Even the AI is still pretty dumb. They walk into your shots, so this might get... To me, this gets really boring after only a little while. I mean, I play mods all the time, and just comparing the AI in some mods to the others, I mean, you could tell the difference. Like in, what's the best AI? I know the Savage AI is one of the best, but there's also, I forgot the name of the AI that they use in Stainless Steel, the Brutal AI or whatever. Alright, we're going to take our ships over here, we're going to steal some trade income, just some little quick make money way at the very beginning. And what else are we going to be doing? Ah, there we go. Going to build all these things. No negativity towards our people, and it raises our money and our growth rate. So we're going to build a lot of those in the very beginning. Got our technology rolling. Now with the ministers, we're going to replace the navy. That doesn't affect... Ooh, alright, immediately we get a good one. And we need a new justice. Good, got him. So it's even better, we got 2 good guys. So we're going to keep it like that for a while. And we're going to lower the taxes. For the people, that is. Not for the nobles. Alright, we're going to start some new trade agreements. And I really don't want to be at war on 2 fronts. You really don't have to worry about Russia. I mean, this is so ironic. It's like you honestly don't have to worry about Russia in the very beginning of this campaign. But historically, the German Empire should focus on Russia first before taking on France and Britain and Belgium. In my last campaign, Belgium was like kicking my ass for a little while. I mean, I beat them back. I took over Denmark. I had to leave an army to garrison it because the area was so like unstable. All right, and I'm gonna keep this army right here. Whenever I start this campaign, Russia tends to attack only East Prussia. That's what they did historically as well, but. I don't know, Russia just ignores Warsaw. They just ignore it entirely, so just defend East Prussia. I'm gonna take all my conscripts, all the soldiers, and cavalry, and bring it right here. Because France is going to start piling up its armies over here. The last campaign, I think... I really want to fight Denmark. I want to take over everybody, but... In this campaign, it's going to take a while to do all that because you have to worry about the AI marching into your boys. And that's going to take a while to kill them all, and you have to do that on the battlefield because if you auto-resolve, you're going to lose unnecessary amount of troops. You really, honestly, don't lose as much as the auto-resolve portrays. It's a bad example. We're going to ignore the supply depots because it raises the unrest in your provinces. So we're gonna just stick with like villages, logging camps, anything that doesn't affect our people's mentality. Alright, because I know a lot of people over here gets pissed when I try to raise the taxes. Alright, policy's going good, ministers, nothing new, trade, nothing's blockaded yet. We're gonna combine our navies. I honestly don't want my navy to be out here in the open, so I'm going to put it right here. It's just far enough away from the British Navy, because the British Navy is huge and very powerful. Alright, some people, this is just judging from my other Great War mod videos, a lot of people are complaining about the historical inaccuracies in this mod. I mean, there's only so much you could do within the game's limit when you try to make a mod. I mean, you're really just leaving open to your creativity. It's not something that you can, I mean, you're not gonna see Hannibal and Caesar in the same campaign in Rome Total War II. It's just not possible. You're not gonna see a mod put those two characters in there, but I'm sure CA will, just for like what ifs situation. But in this mod, there is no airplanes, even though historically there was. There is no Bulgaria. There is no... Cause Bulgaria was part of World War I. You honestly don't get the full extent of the World War I era situation, too. Like, Ottomans only get one province here, which is their capital, but they don't get the rest of Turkey. So, yeah, a lot of people get pissed because of that, but... There's only so much you can do. I mean, the mods tried. I guess the closest you could get to a good representation of World War I would be like a World War I mod for Empire Total War, but I don't know how that would work out. I guess you would combine the American Civil War mod and just overhaul that to where you could fight all over the world, because the Germans, the British, everybody had colonies all over the world during that, even in Africa. But there is no African campaign in Napoleon Total War. There's a Italian campaign, there's a Middle Eastern campaign, and there's the European campaign. That's it. That's all you get. There's only so much you can mod, but that's why most people, that's why the best mods are in Medieval Two Kingdoms, because you could mod the entire world. You could change the map. That's why we have great mods like Westeros, Third Age Total War, Hyrule, Call of Warhammer, The Sundering. Those are all overhaul mods, and they're just beautiful. I mean, if you've seen those mods, these are from lores, fantasy lores, and they got it down to a T. So, it's very difficult trying to mod, like, Napoleon Total War and Shogun 2 Total War. I mean, they're doing that right now because of the recently released mod tools, but that's it. That's all you can do. But those are by far one of my favorite mods. I play Call of Warhammer a lot. I really like the Warhammer universe. It's always nice. Hyrule is cool, but it's like, it's not even a full version of the mod yet. There's a lot of units and features missing, but the guy's busy and he's working a lot. So I can't blame him. I can only appreciate what he's done for me so far. And everybody else. Not just me in particular. But I'm just saying, me as a person that likes to download mods for the challenge, the lore, and I just like it. Call of Warhammer is really interesting. I like the sandbox version better, but with the original version, the full version, it's heavily scripted. And I don't like the fact that the AI gets like these instant armies and money, and it's not fair for the human opponent because there's only so much you can do. Like, you're limited to what you can do. Alright, so we're building up our economy, building up all these villages. I'm still gonna ignore the warehouses and supply depots because it lowers our, yeah, it makes people pissed, and I don't want to make people mad at me. Alright, so gathering up our army, it's a bunch of conscripts, but until we get this one over here, then we'll have like 1.5 armies. Almost 2. Alright, what are we looking up now? Alright, we're gonna try and ignore that. We're gonna get anything and everything that builds up our economy. Alright, we want this because it increases the happiness of the lower classes. Nobility, you don't have to worry about that much. And I would turn on the music. I think there is music, but I don't. I think it's copyrighted. Alright, so this is the spy. Just sabotage it, but there is... oh wait, this was supposed to be a plane, actually. Not a spy. No, we're not going to do that over here. You know what, we're going to spy on Russia. You could really tell when they're coming because you could... You have your line of sight right here, but just in case. I could really use all these troops. I could really use them against France. That's where most of the money is anyway. Paris gets a lot of income. Alright, we're gonna... No, we can't build anything right now. Infrastructure. Build the warehouse. So government looking, no better ministers or anything yet. Trades, not that bad. The Ottomans were blockaded at first. Alright, another turn now. I'm surprised the FPS rates isn't lowering for me. That's good. I hate it when it does that. I get this issue with my computer. I already know the cause of it and all. It's called Com Surrogate. Whenever I play a game or something, it pops up and it causes an extreme amount of memory usage. So I'm using like 96% of my memory when it's done processing for a little while. I'm using 96% of my memory when that Com Surrogate thing starts up. And it has to do with my Windows. It definitely has to do with that. And I don't know how to disable it either. I tried, I thought it was my... I get like a free antivirus thing. It's called AVG. You can download it for free and all, and I'm sure a lot of people use it. But I thought that was the cause of it, because most spywares that you download usually is the cause of any increased memory usage, so I thought maybe that was the cause of it, of course. So I uninstalled it, and it still continued to happen. So I don't know what to do anymore. I don't know what to disable. It has to do with my thumbnails. I looked online. A lot of other people had that same problem. So it has to do with your thumbnail processing. Alright, so what do we do? What do we search up? I really don't want to waste my time looking up this, but... Eh. Fascism. We're gonna go with this. Alright, cool. I really want to be at peace with you, Russia. I don't want to worry about you. I'm sure we could, be at peace with Belgium. I don't want to attack Belgium anyway. We have so many good Total War players that are from Belgium. In my last campaign I played, not the one I posted on YouTube, but I played another. Serbia was actually winning against Austria-Hungary. They were taking over Croatia and everything. It was unbelievable. I'll get these feet. No, I don't need it. And I think I'm just about ready to start attacking. gonna go through the economy real quick. Yeah. I hope Russia doesn't attack me. It's gonna suck. Alright, I guess I'll build this one. Alright, get that going. Belgium doesn't want peace either. What if I give you trade? No. Nobody wants peace. Alright. And I really need a gin. That's for show. I'll buy one next one. If I can afford it. The best gin is usually like 3,200. That's from what I can guess. Yeah. Oh, Russia's making movement. I see an army. I can start recruiting. You know what? I don't trust Russia. I could really use those troops though. You know what? I gotta buy a gin. Best one, 2,500. Fine. We're on our way to France now. Going to attack. Could get nope, can't. I need to build up another army. Come on, Belgium, I don't want to fight you. Yes! Yes, 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 yes! Thank you! Thank you, Belgium! Your agreement in the future. Promise. Russia? Peace? Peace? Peace be with you? No? Serbia? Peace? Oh. Alright. Time to fight France. Okay, their demands, British military tradition, Russian military tradition, join war against Belgium, their offers, colonial recruitment, single payment of 1,000. No. Because I can't fight Belgium while I'm attacking France. That's just, no, no, no. Because usually when I take this, I'll point it out when I get back. Alright. If I take this, Belgium is right here. They just easily attack me. Holy crap. Alright, time to fight them. They got a ton of artillery though. Alright, I gotta fight this on the battlefield. So I'm gonna save. Alright, first battle. And that province really isn't that heavily defended either. I think one of the armies just went past Belgium. They were trying to invade through the Rhine. Battle of Troyes, farmland, 1914. Joseph Coffrey. Joffrey. Alright. Time to sneaky sneak sneak. Alright, let's see the action. I know everybody wants to see this. it's very pleasing to the eye. It's very beautiful. But after a while, it gets really boring because the AI, it's just, yeah. Just keep moving. Oh, they lost their gen. Too bad. I'm gonna destroy their entire army. Oh. Get routed. I don't really need the cav anyway. They're expensive, and they die too quickly, but they're really good for taking out artillery. I don't think they were historically, but whatever. Alright, so the French forces, they're losing to conscripts. Or militia, you could say. Oh, nice shot. So we can just walk. This is such a beautiful mod. Alright, there's a war going on. I gotta... What is all that flickering going on the screen? So only my militia's taking damage, I don't mind. As long as my artillery is covering them, they can win this fight. Beautiful shot. Need one right in the middle. Very nice. Oh, look at this cap charge. So historical. So beautiful, so brave. It's like the War Horse. Have you ever seen that movie? Sad movie. Or read the book. That is it of the French forces. All that's really left is this. But... I bet turning your back to the enemy running away and... It's very scary. I would take cover or hide or separate from the mass of other people. You'd think that would be the primary target for the... mass of people are routing. That is it. They're gonna fall back to their province, their region, their home. They're gonna defend it to the death. We're gonna end it, because I can't pursue them. No more cav. My fault. Entirely my fault. The first job was when the 2 empty. Oh, shoot. Alright, so they definitely lost a lot more than us, and since I only lost mainly my conscripts, this was an okay battle. Alright, so everything... replenish while I can. So total, it looks like they have about, like, a half an army right here. So I have numerical superiority. I don't know how many they have at Paris. Probably a shitload. Now I can follow behind with this army. I don't even know why I buy gins. It's not like the army is gonna rebel. Oh, and speaking of rebellions, you can have a rebellion at your home, and it will change your type of government. I feel like it's more special when you're the Russians and that happens, because then you could start the Soviet Union. Trade routes possible when... Oh, the shopping center. We'll call it Walmart. Alright, so research 3 turns for that each. Alright, one more chance to close one front. Nope. Gonna work. Serbia. Nope. At least I don't have to fight Belgium. That's all that matters. And Russia is really suspicious. It's just standing there. But I don't have to worry about Russia. Though historically, the German Empire should have used their Stifling plan or whatever it's called. I just can't pronounce it. I know it starts with an S, but this is the plan where they, just to avoid fighting on two fronts, they wanted a plan where they just go all out very quickly against one enemy through neutral, otherwise neutral countries, so they could gain the element of surprise. They went through Belgium, and that didn't go quite as planned because Belgium had more resistance than they were expecting, so go Belgium. Alright, we're gonna take our units. Wonder if I should bring it back over here. Gonna reinforce with new units. Could reinforce with 5. Gonna see this place. Yep, get them out. Let's scout a little bit. Oh, there's Vinny. Gonna cut off their trade a little bit. Oh, nice. I think we got France off completely by surprise. Industrial mills. No, it's gonna lower happiness. I don't want to do that. I want them to be very happy and healthy. Alright, we're gonna get the city council. Nothing else useful that I can get. Just put a few of these. Alright, so my economy's not doing that bad, actually. A lot of people are getting upset because I built a couple... Let me help my dog. I'll be right back. I'm back. Just had to help my dog. He's too fat to jump up on the bed, so I have to get up and help him. Alright, so everybody's not that mad or upset, so that's good. At least we won't have any revolts or riots or anything. I won't have to send any garrisons to stay home while I need all my troops on the front. So I'm gonna end this turn. And shoot, I'm gonna lose a few troops in my army right there. So I'm going to basically have like half an army defending East Prussia from Russia. Oh, when I'm being attacked. Oh, snap. We could beat them. That's for show. I think I'm going to retreat anyway. Alright, we have to attack. Battle of France, 1914. I would auto-resolve, but I'm just going to lose an unnecessary amount of troops. I could deal probably the same amount of damage to them if I just attack. And we're going to flank with our gen. Oh no. I'm gonna be shooting them while they're in the forest too, that sucks. Alright, we're shooting. While they're distracted. Oh no. I'll attack their artillery now while they're distracted. While they're in the forest, I'm not gonna be able to do too much damage. Doing a good amount of damage to this one outside the forest, and I'm gonna be able to kill these artillery. It's the djinn. Beautiful. Come on, sneak on through to the other one. That djinn is a ninja. Don't mind the cavalry at your back. Just gonna take out your artillery. Just keep focusing on the infantry in front of you. Alright, this one's about to rout. Alright, I'm gonna stop recording real quick. I wanna see my processor. Alright, everything's processing okay. I'm just getting a little bit of lag spike because I'm using Fraps. I hate Fraps. I would rather use Shadowplay, but whenever I use Shadowplay in my Vegas Pro, it always crashes and corrupts. Alright, so we're gonna get that artillery. Alright, cool. We'll continue a little bit, shoot at him. Chase them for a little bit just so they don't regroup. I wish this was like medieval Two Kingdom mechanics where you could just kill routing units in droves very quickly. But instead, they just kill them by, you know, one by one. So I'm gonna end it. Heroic victory. Nice. Killed their artillery at least, so we don't have to face that again. That's always cool. That was the only reason why the auto-resolve balance of power bar was so heavily in their favor, because they had the artillery. So we lost about half of what they lost, but we had more troops anyway. And there were conscripts. Opportunity to intercept. Nah, we're not gonna. I don't want to stop my siege. Alright, gonna settle you in here. That's gonna replenish our troops. And what else? I really want to increase the replenishment rate, so I'm going to start building the infrastructure. Alright, so these people, they're going to start losing troops every turn. And I'm going to retreat with you. Oh, we're gonna go back here and replenish. Alright, I'm going to continue a siege. They'll just draw all their troops to me. So whatever armies they do have, they're just going to meet me here, and I could just defeat them all in the field of battle. So that concludes this first episode of The Great War Mod as the German Empire again. This is the Great War Mod 5.1.4. Hope you all download it. The link will be in the video description. Thank you for watching again, and I'll see you all next time.